family that we've ever sponsored here on one stage. Let's get up on your feet and give a hand for the Clancy family reunion.
Robbie O'Connell.
Hello.
Our nephew. My son, Donal Clancy.
Hello.
I'm Liam Clancy. This is Bobby Clancy. This is Finbarr. Aoife has just gone off to the bathroom. Or something. And we have Bob Dylan's son, Eddie Dillon, over here.
Saddle up his master steed.
of the whistling gypsy road. Mansion fine, down by the river plaining, and there was music, and there was wine, but the gypsy and his lady.
Level up here is something else, you have no idea. But I'm a woman, I can handle it, don't worry. This is a song called Mantles of Green, and it's a love song, traditional love song.
My love came to Dublin one fine summer.
Sunday morning. Now they are falling, there's wind in the bough, and I never asked him to pay me a ring. Fall down very lightly, or he's a meal. Not as the clergy is in the chapel. Branches and ask them to raise up their arms in the air. And I'll make him some shoes of the finest green leather. I'll make him a cloak the finest you've seen. And he'll city of Dublin, and I'll walk beside him in mantles of green. Yes, he'll walk like a lord through the city of Dublin, and I'll walk beside him in mantles of green.
So my mother told me, Timmy, way all the way, we'll all the way go. That if I did not kiss the girls, my lips would all grow moldy, Timmy, way all the way, we'll all the way go. And way all the way, the good ship now is rolling, Timmy, way all the way, we'll all the way show. King Louis was the king of France before the revolution. Way all the way, we'll all the way show. And then he got his head chopped off, it spoiled his constitution. Way all the way, we'll all the way show. Well, first I met a Yankee girl, and she was fat and lazy, Timmy. Way all the way, we'll all the way go. And then I met an Irish girl, she damn near drove me crazy, Timmy. Way all the way, we'll all the way go. St. Patrick was a gentleman, he came from decent people, Timmy. Way all the way, we'll all the way go. He built a church in Dublin town, and on it put a steeple, Timmy. Way all the way, we'll all the way go. And way all the way, we're bound for better weather, Timmy. Way all the way, we'll all the way.
Thank you. Now we're going to get our long-lost cousin, Eddie Dillon, to play a little tune on the guitar for us.
A tune off my latest CD, it's called The Bar.
And for that reason, I'm going to sing a different song. I'm going to take you back in time to the Second World War, where a man called Leo Marx, who was an intelligence officer for the Allied forces, and also responsible for sending codes to the spies behind the enemy lines. And they say that he fell in love with one of the spies. Her name is Violette Jappe. And one of the codes he sent to her was in the form of a short love poem. And the poem simply says, "The life that I have is all that I have. And the life that I have is yours. The love that I have of the life that I have is yours and yours and yours. The sleep I shall have, the rest I shall have, yet death will be but a pause for the peace of my years, and the long green grass will be yours and yours and yours. Underneath the lamplight by the barbecue, darling, I remember it's there you used to wait, there that you whispered tenderly that you love me and always be. But nearly on the lamplight, my only darling, time has come for roll call, time for us to part. Darling, I'll caress you and press you to my heart, there where that lantern softly beams, your sweet face seems to haunt my dream. My lily of the lamplight, my only darling, orders came for sailing somewhere over there, all confined to barracks, it's more than I could bear. I knew you were waiting in the street, I heard your feet, but could not meet. My lily of the lamplight, my only darling, resting in the village just behind the line. Even though we parted, your lips are close to mine, there in that far off.
Still couldn't get the lid off the goddamn thing.
That's about the size of it, isn't it? Okay, I just... It's hardly the right introduction for a love song. But this is one I know you can sing very quietly on the chorus with. It says, let us go to the banks of the ocean where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me.
The Dutchman not the kind of man to keep his thumb jammed in the dam and holds his dreams in. But that's a secret only Margaret knows. When Amsterdam is golden in the morning, Margaret brings him breakfast. She believes him. He thinks the tulips bloom beneath the snow. He's mad as he can be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes. Sometimes she sees her unborn children in his eyes. Oh, let us go to the banks of the ocean, above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. The Dutchman still wears wooden shoes, his cap and coat are patched with love that Margaret sold him. Sometimes he thinks he's still in Rotterdam. He watches tugboats down canals and calls out when he thinks he knows the captain. Till Margaret comes to take him home again. forgiving streets, a trippin' all she holds his arm. Sometimes he thinks that he's alone, and he calls her name. The windmill swirled a winter in, she winds his buckle tighter, they sit in the kitchen, and the tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. He sees her for a moment, calls her name, she makes his bed up, humming some old love song. She learned it when the tune was very new. He hums a line or two, they hum together in the night. The Dutchman falls asleep and Margaret blows the candle out.
Sing a song that I only heard from my mother, who got it from my grandmother. None of the folklorists of Ireland ever heard it. It came from a woman, our grandmother, named Ma McGraw, their great-grandmother. And it's called, she ran a pub in the middle of the main street of our hometown of Carrick-on-Shore, and she used to sing this song called Whiskey, You're the Divil.
We're marching off to Portugal and Spain. Drums are beating, banners flying, the divil a home will come tonight. Love, fare thee well. Into the air you will come down, into the air you will come down. Here I spot to a lady, oh, there's whiskey in the jar. For the pension might be lonely, then he'd die in hot and lonely. Give every man his flask of powder and spare lot on his shoulder. Love, fare thee well. Whiskey, you're the devil, for you're laid in the astray. Over hills and mountains and to a merry day. You're swayed and stronger days and there you're spunky or your tay. Oh, whiskey, you're me darling, drunk or sober. Wrong me, don't take me, don't all above me. For if you do, I will torment you after death. He goes from on to low, fairly well. Put you to the V.I.O. to the Dumb Dumb, to the V.I.O. to the Dumb Dumb. He writes for Tura Lanny, for this whiskey in the dark. Whiskey, oh, the devil made me astray. Over hills and mountains and to America. Your slave is wrong, but they sister, your spunky arm and tail. Oh, whiskey, oh, the God of broke the sober.
If you would, to picture a scene, if you could imagine in your mind's eye a little convent on the outskirts of some small town in Ireland where nothing much ever happens, you know, the same old routine's been going on for the last couple of hundred years, and then suddenly one day from out of the blue there arrives a very strange disheveled looking nun who comes up to the convent door saying that she has orders to move in. Now I'm sure back in the old days they would have taken a whole lot more time to check on her credentials. But you know, recent years, the number of recruits has dropped off very drastically. They didn't want to let one slip away, not a live one anyway. So they took her in. And in the following weeks and months, she totally disrupted the whole routine of the convent with all kinds of weird and bizarre behavior. Finally, one morning, a police car pulls up to the convent door. All these policemen jump out, they have an arrest warrant for the sister Josephine. And the whole story begins to unfold. Oh, sister Josephine, what do all these policemen mean? Coming to the convent in their grim limousine. After sister Josephine, while you, sister Josephine, sit with your boots upon the altar screen. Smoke one last cigar. What a funny nun you are. The policemen say that Josephine is a terrorist in disguise. For 15 months and more been on the run. The sisters don't believe it, no, that can't be Josephine. Just think about her tenderness towards the younger nuns. Oh, sister Josephine, they're searching the chapel where you've been seen. Crannies at the nun's canteen. After sister Josephine, while you, sister Josephine, take a farewell sip of Benedictine before your au revoir. What a funny nun you are. No longer will her snores be heard at chapel during prayers, or her lustful moanings fill the stilly night. No more empty bottles of altar wine come plunking from her cell. No longer will the cloistered toilet seat stand upright. Oh, sister Josephine, founder of the convent poker team. They're searching through your bundles of Playboy magazine. After sister Josephine, while you, sister Josephine, give a farewell sniff of Benzedrine. The convent, put your regard. What a funny nun you are. Admittedly, her hands were strong and hairy and embellished with a curious tattoo. Admittedly, her voice was on the deep side. She seemed to shave more often than the other sisters do. Oh, sister Josephine, streaking through the suburbs when last seen, dressed only in your BBDs and rosary. What a funny nun you seem to be.
Thank Together we will plunder and together we will die. We'll wander o'er the valleys, we'll gallop o'er the plains. We'll scorn to live in slavery, bound down in iron chains. Poor but honest parents, he was born in Castlemaine. He was his father's only hope, his mother's only joy. And dearly did his parents love their wild but old and born. At scarcely 16 years of age, he left his father's home. And to Australia's sunny clime, a boat ranger he roamed. Hear of those wealthy squatters, and their stuffy days astray. And tell her to Australia was the wild colonial boy. So come on, army hearties, we'll roam the mountains high. Together we will wander and together we will die. We'll wander o'er the valleys, we'll gallop o'er the plains. We'll scorn to live in slavery, bound down in iron chains. 61, the staring youth commences his wild career. With a heart and no danger, no home and any fear. He beats the temples and he runs judgmental boy. Who trembles and gave up his gold to the wild colonial boy. One day as he was rambling the mountainside alone, listening to those little birds and lemon laughing songs. Of those renowned and silver Kelly, Davis and Fitzroy, they swore that they would capture him, the wild colonial boy. Plunder and together we will die. We'll wander o'er the valleys, we'll gallop o'er the plains. We'll scorn to live in slavery, bound down in iron chains. Surrender now, Jack Dolan, for you see we're 3-1. Surrender now, Jack Dolan, for your life will not be long. Jack pulled a pistol from his belt, he shook it up on high. I fight but not surrender, said the wild colonial boy. Where the trooper carried and he brought him to the ground. And turning round to David, he let the mortal wound. A shovel through the jaw he made, still firing at his roar. And that's the way they captured him, the wild colonial boy. So come on, army hearts, we'll roam the mountains high. Together we will plunder and together we will die. We'll wander o'er the valleys, we'll gallop o'er the plains. We'll scorn to live in slavery, bound down in iron chains. Summertime is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? And will
together to the wild Because they're about to throw us out of the grounds any minute. We're going to be back tomorrow and the day after at the earlier times. I think tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. So we hope to see you all then when you're not so sleepy as you are tonight. This is a song that we sometimes regret that we ever recorded. It's been the most used and abused song that has ever come out of Ireland, although it originated in Australia. That's a good one. It's been sung around the world in every language, in every pub on St. Patrick's Day. It's the most peed on and thrown up on song on the face of the earth. And it says, no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more will I play the Wild Rover. What, never? No, never, no more. And it's no, nay, never.
And I told the landlady my money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Such a custom as yours I could have any day. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never. And the landlady eyed over the wine with delight. She said, I had whiskey and the wine's on the best. And the words that I said to her were only in jest. And it's no, nay, never.
Freezing your tootsies off out there? Never thought I'd see the day in Milwaukee in the summer when we'd be freezing like
this. I know, but it's freezing up here.
Now, if you jump up and down, you'll keep warm.
Just follow lead.
And we were not far from the land. Our captain, he spied a mermaid so fair, with a comb and glass in her hand. And the ocean waves do roar, and the stormy winds do blow. And we poor sailors are skipping at the top, while the landlubbers light out below, below, below.
Of our gallant ship, a fine old man was he. Sail this pretty mermaid, as stormy of our doom, we shall sink to the bottom of the sea.
Right. And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow. And we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, below, below.
Cabin by our gallant ship, and a well-spoken lad was he. Saying, I have a sweetheart and sailing by the sea, and tonight she'll be dreaming of me.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, while the landlubbers lie down below.
And a crazy old butcher was he. Said, I care much more for my thoughts and my hands than I do for the fun of the sea.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, below, below.
Soldier was he. He said, I have a wife in Brooklyn by the sea. Tonight, a widow she will be.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow. We poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, below, below. Where the landlubbers lie down below.
That's the way it was. This is my son, Donal, who is 25 today.
Happy birthday!
And every one of you are going to buy him a drink afterwards. I'm Liam, the youngest, the handsomest, the richest of the group.
After me.
This is Bobby Clancy.
My son, Finbarr. My daughter, Aoife, and our cousin, Eddie Dillon.
He's not a cousin, actually. He's a...
He's cousin Eddie.
He's son of Bob Dillon.
Relation to a drink.
Relation to a drink. I'll go along with that. The next song incorporates in the very title two of my favorite subjects in the world. It's called Nancy Whiskey.
My thirst, it was my need. I tried to rise, but I was not able. Nancy had me by the knee.
Whiskey, whiskey, Nancy, whiskey. Whiskey, whiskey, Nancy, oh.
Events in Ireland is an annual horse race that's held every year. That's why it's annual. Today you'll find fiddlers and dancers and pipers, trick-of-the-loop men, general troublemakers, and people like ourselves. Crew bean eaters. Whip me whack, haul the dough, haul the dithery idle day, and whip me whack. As I rode out to Galway town to see the recreation of the 17th of August, behind me elevated, there were multitudes assembled with their tickets at the station. The eyes began to dazzle and I rode to see the races. With me went for the door, for the jewelry idle day. Tis there you see confectioners with sugar sticks and dainties, with lozenges and oranges and lemonade. Gingerbread and spices to accommodate the ladies, and a big ruby for thruppence to be picking while you're waiting.
With me whack, all the dough, all the dithery
idle day. Each day you'll see the pipers and the fiddlers competing, the nimble running dancers, and they tripping on the daisies. Others prank cigars and lights and bills for all the races, the colours of the jockeys and the frights and horses eating.
With me whack, all the dough.
And they mounted on so safely, the king, the blue, the orange,
green, the emblem of our nation. When the fire was on for start and all the horses seemed impatient, I thought they'd never stood on ground. They seemed to be so built and went they back while the dough, while the doodling island lay. There was half a million people there of all denominations. The Catholic, the Protestant, the Jew, the Presbyterian, there was it, no animosity, no matter what persuasion. But fortune, hospitality, it juiced and fresh and waited. With me what? For the dough, for the doodly idle day. With me what? For the dough, for the doodly idle
day. And I'm sure you've all heard of Murphy's Law. Yeah. Haven't you? Yeah. Oh, okay, sorry. Wrong song. We'll do it in a minute. We're going to do an old Scottish song. It's actually a very old song, several hundred years old, called The Broom of the Cowden Owls. And the words probably won't make it, the chorus won't make a whole lot of sense to you, but if you can pick it up, try singing along with us anyway.
Now
I be in the Northumbrie, higher than our father's yow.
Back to Murphy's Law, I guess we already had a touch of it. You know how it goes, anything that possibly can go wrong will, and usually at the worst possible time. There's a great old song that illustrates Murphy's Law just about better than anything else, about a poor misfortunate Irishman working on a building site one time. And he had one of those days, you know, those days that start out bad and get progressively worse as they go along. We all get them from time to time. But this poor fellow, by the end of the day, was in terrible shape altogether. He was unable to go to work at all for weeks on end. And his problem was that he had to write a letter to his boss to explain what had happened to him and why he was unable to go into work. The song's called Dear Boss. Dear boss, I write this note to you to tell you of my plight. And at the time of writing, I am not a pretty sight. Me body is all black and blue and me face a deadly grey. And I hope you'll understand why Paddy's not at work today. I was working on the 14th floor, some bricks I had to clear. I'd thrown him down from such a height was not a good idea. The foreman wasn't very pleased, he'd been an awful sod. And he said I'd have to take them down the ladder in me hod. Now shifting all those bricks by hand, it seems so awful slow. So I hoisted up a barrel and secured a rope below. But in my haste to do the job, I was too blind to see that a barrel full of building bricks was heavier than me. Now when I came down, I cut the rope and the barrel fell like lead. And clinging tightly to the rope, I started up instead. I shot up like a rocket, and to my dismay, I found that halfway up, I met the bloody barrel coming down. Now the barrel broke me shoulder as to the ground it sped. And when I reached the top, I struck the pulley with me head. I still clung on, though numbed and shocked. And this almighty blow, and the barrel spilled out half the bricks, 14 floors below. Now when the bricks had fallen from the barrel to the floor, tried then outweighed the barrel and I started down once more. Still clinging tightly to the rope, I headed for the ground, and I fell among the broken bricks that were all scattered around. As I lay there mourning on the floor, sure I thought I'd passed the worst. When the barrel struck the pulley wheel and didn't the bottom burst, a shower of bricks came down on me, sure I hadn't got a hope. And as I was losing consciousness, I let go the bloody rope. Now, the barrel, it being heavier, it started down once more, and it landed right across me as I lay there on the floor. I broke three ribs and my left arm, and I can only say that I hope you'll understand why Paddy's not at work today.
Is a song that I just learned recently from a movie that I've seen called A Love Divided, and it was originally a Scottish poem that was written by Robbie Burns and was put to music, but I thought it was such a beautiful song that I should learn it off for the weekend, so here it goes. It's called A Fond Kiss.
Hey, fond are never parted, had we ne'er been broken hearted. Heavy were the first and fairest. Joy and treasure, peace, enjoyment, love and pleasure. Hate on kiss and pain we sever. Hate farewell and then forever. Deep in heart from tears I'll pledge thee, pouring sighs and groans I wedge thee.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I'd like to this next tune. It's off my latest instrumental CD. And I'd like to dedicate it to my niece who's right over here, Leanne.
Settled low. It was just a five aboard her when she finally was awash. We worked like hell to save her, all needless of the cost. But the groan she gave as she went down, it caused us to proclaim we'd make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. years of service, then let our sorry end. The insurance paid the loss to us, so let her rest below. They laughed at us and said we have to go. But we talked to her all winter, some days around the clock. She's worth a $250,000 of floating at the dock. And with every chart that hit the bar, we swore we would remain and make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Rise again, oh rise again. And our name not be lost to the knowledge of men. For all those who loved her best and were with her till the end will make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. All spring now we've been with her on a barge lent by a friend. Twice I've had the bends. Thank God it's only 60 feet and the currents here are slow, or I'd never have the strength to go below. But we patched her rents and stopped her vents, dog hatch and portal down, put cables to her fore and aft and girded her around. And tomorrow noon we hit the air and then take up the strain and watch the Mary Ellen Carter rise again.
In another day. All you to whom adversity has dealt the final blow, with smiling bastards lying to you everywhere you go, turn to and put out all your strength of arm, heart and brain, and like the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Be it a home, a love, a friend, like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again. What more diversion can I desire than to sit them down or beside the fire?
What more diversion can I desire than to sit them down or beside the fire?
And in his hand a jug of punch, I had on his knee a tidy wench, Landy Baldy.
Landy Baldy, skiddy and diddle dum, skiddy and diddle dum,
what more hardship can a boy endure than to sit him down or behind the door?
What more hardship can a boy endure than to sit him down or behind the door?
And in his hand a hot jug of punch, I am on his knee, the hot tidy wench, let me follow the dees.
When I am dead, my drinking's over, I'll take one drink and I'll drink no more.
When I am dead and my drinking's over, I'll take one drink while it's to the fore.
In case I might get a car that day, I will take it now and I'll drink away.
When I am dead, I end in my mold, and my head and feet leave a flowing mold.
When I am dead, I end in my mold, and my head and feet leave a flowing mold.
And every young man that passes by, he can take a drink and remember I'll at least follow the dish.
I'm always thinking
County Clare.
For the rest, we play an instrumental tune, Robbie and myself.
I'm going to give you a scene now in a doctor's office where the doctor is looking at his new patient, and he said to the new patient, "For a man of 60 years of age, you're in fantastic shape," he says. And this guy, being an old crabbed guy, didn't give in so easily. He stood back, kept silence, looked at the doctor angry and said to him, "Did I say I was 60? Did I? Did I say I was 60? I am 68 years of age." The doctor said, "That's fantastic. That's even better," he says. He says, "Your father must have lived a long time." Silence. "Did I say my father was dead? Did I? Did I say my father was dead? My father is 104. 104. My God, you're a long-living family. When did your grandfather die?" Silence. "My grandfather is 124 and still alive, and he's getting married next month." The doctor looked at him. "I don't believe this," he said. "I don't believe this. 124 and he's getting married next month? Why would any man of 124 want to get married?" Silence. "Did I say he wanted to get married?" This song... This song leads into a song that says he's got no forlorum. And the punchline of this, you have to give us a hand on this song, by the way. He's got no forlorum. When you hear the word lost, you shout out in your fullest voice, "He's lost his ding dorum." Have you got that? You want to try it out? "He's got no forlorum, he's lost his
ding dorum."
Now you're talking. "An old man came courting me, hey, to my darling. An old man came courting me, baby, beyond. An old man came courting me, he did propose to me. Thanks when you're young. Never wed an old man." I got a pump. "I got no forlorum, a little forlorum. He's got no forlorum, a little forlorum. He's got no forlorum, me lost his
ding dorum.
So days when you're young, never wed an old man." When we went to our
was he, hey, doing with Armandy, when we went to her tea, leaving young. When we went to her tea, he started teasing me, mate, when you're young, never let an old man. But he got no valor, a little valor, he's got no valor, a little valet. He got no valor, and me lusty,
senor.
So, mate, when you're young, never let an old man. When we went to the church, hey, do whom and already. When we went to the church, leaving young. When we went to the church, he near left me in the lurch. Mates, when you're young, never went at all. But he's got no valor, a little valor. He's got no valor, a little valor. He's got no valor, and we lost it. So, mates, when you're young, never went at all. When we went to her bed, Angel was on the feet. When we went to her bed, leaving young. When we went to her behavior, the dunner said, mate, when you're young, never wed an old man. But he's got no valor, a little valor. He's got no valor, a little valor. He's got no valor, a little
valor.
So, mate, when you're young, never wed.
When he was fast asleep, me being young, and I thought you had to get all this. When he was fast asleep, I went in 83. The arms of a handsome young man is old.
He's got the Lord, a little valor. Yes, he's got the Lord, a little valor. Yes, he's got the Lord, he's pounding
fingers.
So think when you're young, never wait.
Did you notice that his mic stand could have done with some Viagra? What does that say about himself?
He's obviously doing fine.
In the year of our Lord
1866, set sail from the cold hill port. We were sailing away
with Wake. And it was actually based on the old vaudeville song of Tim Finnegan's Wake, which we're about to sing for you, but by way of introduction to the song, Liam would now like to recite for you the entire novel by James Joyce, Finnegan's Wake.
Tell you what, I know that we have many scholars out in Milwaukee here. Chuck or Ed Ward could recite this for you any day of the week. So I'd like to change it around a bit. I'd like to start at the end and recite it for you backwards. There's where first we passed through grass, we hushed the bush to wish. A gull, gulls, far calls, coming far, end here, us then, Finnegan, take us softly, remember me, till thousands thee the keys to give him away, alone, aloud, along, the last, the... River on, past even Adams from swerve of shore to bend of bay takes us by a commodious vitus of recirculation back to Howth Castle and environs, and big Mr. Finnegan of the stuttering hand, free man's maurer lived in the broadest way imaginable in his rush slip too far back from Messuages before Joshua and Judges had given us numbers, our Helveticus had committed Deuteronomy. During mighty odd years, this man of hot cemented edifices in Chopper's Thorpe, while Bildung super Bildung upon the banks of the livers for the song souls, a Woolworth of a skyscraper of most Eiffel height entirely originating from next to nothing, with a burning bush above of its bobble top, And when Lawrence O'Toole's is clithering up and Thomas O'Bucket's clattering down, and the first was he to bear arms and a name. Wassily, boozily of Rosengaborn. Oh, Mr. Finn, you're going to be fine again. Ah, Mr. Fun, you're going to be Mr. Finn again. But Dim, he stuttered from the lather, and damn, he was dead. Tim
Finnegan lived in Walking Street, a gentle Irishman by the arm. He had a role so rich and sweet, and a right in the world he carried on. Seeing a sort of a tippler's way, with the love of a little more tingle for, and the man who's worked each day, to drop the parade or everyone. What will the man of Nancy a man to write the role of your father's ship? He's going to live the truth and tell you lots of fun in Finnegan's way.
One morning Tim felt rather cold, which made him shake, and he fell from the ladder and he broke his skull. Well, they carried him home as corpsed away. They rolled him up in a nice clean sheet, and they laid him out upon the bed with a gallon of whiskey at his feet and a bottle of porter on his head.
They spread the samba that the week, and Mrs. Finnegan called for lunch. But she served them tea and cake, then pipes, tobacco, and whiskey punch. Biddy O'Brien began to cry. What a nice thing cost did you ever see? Tim of Olding, why did you die? And a howdy of God said, Finnegan,
and what for the man of a nasty amount of rent before your father's shame? What a nigger, they told you lots of fun at Finnegan's way.
The megaphone took up the job. Oh, Biddy, says she, you're wrong, I'm sure. But Biddy hit her a belt in the gob and left her sprawling on the floor. Then the ward it soon engaged. 'Twas Walter Woman and Manhattan. Shillelagh lots all the rage, and around her up she turned and ran. Back on the land, oh, thank you, man, to run the door, your brother's shame. One day, the truth I told you, lots of fun, and can you get away?
Biddy Maloney ducked his head when a bucket of whiskey flew at him. It missed and fallen on the bed. The liquor scatters over Tim, and may God he revives. See how he rises. Timothy rising from the bed, saying, "Whip your whiskey around like blazes. Tell them, Jesus, do you think I'm dead?
What a minute.
When we'll be on at 5 o'clock, we hope to see you all back here. Until then, we're going to leave you with the most used and abused song that has ever been recorded.